Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I got this colorful green smoky eye look. I don't normally wear colors like this on my eyes. I usually tend to stick to a neutral color, but you know, quarantine's got me stepping outside of the box. So if you guys want to see how I got this look, definitely keep on watching and all products will be listed below. So to start, I'm using these Pixi BeautifEYE eye pads for my under eyes. These are super hydrating and brightening. They are packed with serum, so I like to go ahead and pat the excess serum into my skin for some added benefits. And then I'm gonna go ahead and fill my eyebrows in using this pencil. I generally use the NYX Microbrow pencil, but the store was sold out, so we are using this one. I am not too picky about my brows. I just like to make sure there's no like bald spots or, you know, patchiness or anything like that. And now I'm just taking this Milani eyeshadow primer. I'm only taking a small amount. You only need a little bit of this. It does go a long way. And then I'm taking this light brown color from the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm applying that all over the lid and just a little bit above the crease as well, blending that out with a fluffy brush. And then I'm gonna take that same fluffy brush, dip right back into that brown color, and I'm gonna concentrate that color in my crease just to give my eye a little bit of definition and depth. So now I'm taking this teal sort of green color, and I'm applying that all over the lid also, but I'm keeping this just under my crease. So I'm not gonna take it and kind of like, you know, blow it out. I'm gonna concentrate the color mostly in the outer corners of my eyes, and then I'm gonna blend that out with a fluffy brush as well. I'm just taking a little bit of MAC Fix Plus Spray, and I'm wetting my brush and applying this sparkly teal color all over the lid, just directly on top of the other colors that we placed. And again, I'm just applying it to the lid and blending it out. I like to do this little swipey motion to help kind of clean up the eyeshadow. And then I'm taking this reddish brown color, and I'm gonna just concentrate that color in the crease and in the outer corners and blend that out as well. Most smoky eye looks just involve a lot of blending, so you wanna make sure you have a lot of brushes on hand. And I'm reapplying that sparkly teal color because I did lose some of that to the blending. Now I'm taking this black eyeliner by Avon. This is their luxury eye pencil. This is one of my favorite eye pencils to use. It's very easy to work with. It smudges out very easily and it's long lasting. So I'm just applying that to my upper lash line and I'm blending that out with a pencil brush. I'm just taking some lashes. I'm gonna go ahead and bend them to make them just a little bit easier to apply. I'm taking some adhesive, applying that to the lash band. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply my lashes. It always helps to look down into a mirror for me when I do my lashes. The angles makes it a lot easier to work with. And then I'm again reapplying that sparkly green shadow because I did lose some of it. And all of the steps I did on the upper eyelids, I'm doing on my lower lash line. So I am applying that teal color into the lower lash line, and then I'm going over top of that with that sparkly teal color as well. Now for skin, I am taking my Skinglass by North Face. You guys know, I don't even have to say anything. And I'm applying that all over. This is definitely gonna help give me that glow that I love. And I am using Estee Lauder's Double Wear Foundation. I've recently started using this stuff and I really like it. It's more full coverage than I'm usually used to, but I do like that flawless finish that it does give off, and I like the color as well. It's a good match for me. Taking this Maybelline Fit Me concealer, and I'm gonna apply some to my under eyes. I'm kind of going for soft glam for this, so I am kind of, you know, going overboard on this. My favorite concealer brush to use ever is this e.l.f. Concealer brush. I don't know why I'm doing that on my hand. I was trying to show you guys that it's really soft, like you guys could feel it, but it's really soft and it blends out concealer really, really well. So I usually use the concealer brush and then I'll take a beauty blender and just pat on top of that. And now I'm taking this MAC Prep and Prime, and like I said, I was going for soft glam. So we are definitely going overboard, and I am applying that under the eyes for some more highlight. And to contour, I'm using this Pur Cosmetics Concealer Pen. And I'm just going over my cheekbones and my forehead and the nose. Lately, I've really been liking using a brush to blend out my foundations and my concealers. I used to love using a beauty blender. But I don't know what it is. Lately, I've been loving the brush finish. And so I'm taking this powder by Range Beauty. I've just recently tried this and I kind of like it. It's a little bit more full coverage than I like. I have really dry skin, so I have to be careful. And then I'm applying this brush by Milani just to give some color back into my face. Now for some bronzer, I'm using this bronzer by Guerlain in Terracotta, and this is a mineral bronzer. I really like this as well. It gives me that tan look without being orange. Now for highlight, I'm taking my Skinglass by North Face powder, spraying my brush with the MAC Fix Plus, and I'm just using what's in the cap, and I'm gonna apply that to my cheekbones. And I also like to bring that color up into my brow bone. And for the lips, I'm using Fenty Beauty Stunner Lip Paint and this NYX pencil. And I like to pat my lips to kind of soften it and kind of feather the look out as well. It just gives it a softer look, in my opinion. Now to set the look, I'm just using this Morphe setting spray. And that's it, guys. Super easy. It really didn't take that long. So if you guys like this, please go ahead, give this a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe. Bye.